On Tuesday, January 15, a town meeting was held in Annandale at the United Methodist Church to discuss topics of interest to local citizens.
Welcome, and thank you all so much for coming. We're so happy to have you here tonight for the East District Council Town Hall, and we want to thank all of you for coming.
The meeting opened with the review of the top 10 neighborhood concerns in the area as collected by an online survey that ran for about a month and a half. The items identified in the survey were condition of roads and businesses, speeding in neighborhoods, boarding houses, traffic congestion, infrastructure, crime, property maintenance, snow removal, business development, and gangs. A panel of local officials was at the meeting to address citizens' concerns. One by one, the officials addressed the survey results with the audience.
Speeding is an ongoing issue. It is an issue that I wish I could have a key, a mitigating factor, or anything that I could prevent. It is a situation that I try to manage every day. Since last year, I obtained a full-time traffic enforcement officer, Officer Chrissy Broadbent, and this is her full-time job, is to enforce traffic laws. However, we also have over 120 officers who are on a day-to-day basis conduct enforcement effort as well.
There's no reason we can't do that in our downtown areas also, and just do community cleanups more than once or twice a year. It's a wonderful volunteer activity. I've done it myself. I have picked up more cigarette butts at stoplights than I care to count. All right. But that's a wonderful opportunity. One of the things that was mentioned at the beginning was, you know, volunteering, doing things, you know, what are we gonna do as we meet here? We have these organizations already set up. They need to be populated.
If you have an individual property that you're concerned about and you think there may be a violation, please give our office a call once again. The number is 324-1300, and give us the address of the property, complete address, your name and number. In general, you can go onto the county website if you go to the Department of Planning and Zoning, if you just want to educate yourself about general regulations, the zoning ordinance is on the county website. So.
Bailey's Elementary School and Glen Forest Elementary Schools, there are only two of those that are overcrowded in our area, but they are two of the worst. We have 1,328 students in Bailey's Elementary School. That is a stunning number. That is the size of a small high school. I'm going to give you one more number about Bailey's, and it's 256. 256 is the number of kindergartners we have at Bailey's Elementary School this year. If you double that, that's the size of a normal elementary school. We have huge numbers, and they're not diminishing.
There was also a very lively question and answer session with the local citizens.
Good evening. First of all, thank you for being here. When you first spoke, you mentioned that the loiterers weren't doing anything wrong, but now we just heard that the loitering has contributed to problems on Route 50. Is the county looking at the underlying reasons of why the loitering is happening, such as overcrowding in apartments, and the fact that although they may not be doing anything wrong on the sidewalks, they could be leading to crimes if they have no work, and all the other problems that go along with that?
Thank you for that question. You're absolutely correct. We are sensitive to balancing enforcement versus harassment, I guess. That's what I really was trying to get at.
The meeting lasted until well after 9 p.m. This is Bob Kovacs reporting for Annandale Arts.